2 o'clock on the nose. That'll be Ferguson.
She'll be easy to crack.
Right, Vera. Let's take it from the top. Watch this 20.
You can read. We had to replace an iron.
That iron wasn't worth 5 bob.
You can argue all you like, Ferguson, but that's all you're getting and more than you deserve.
Ferguson, anybody think you didn't want to get out of here?
Yeah, well, I'm still trying to figure out how much you lot have done me out of. Geez, you know how to charge for a few bits of broken furniture.
Furniture wasn't the only thing you broke.
Oh, no. Well, sorry about that crack on the head. It was an accident. I didn't mean it.
That's your trouble. You never do. It's that bad temper of yours that landed you in here in the first place. Just make sure it doesn't happen again.
No worries. Once the sale of the shop comes through, I'm taking Fred on a second honeymoon. Start afresh.
That'll be nice.
Yeah, that lawyer, Wilson, he's handling the sale of the shop for me. Should have a nice tidy bit over even after I pay his fees. Yeah, we'll see you, Mrs. Jackson.
I hope not.
Yeah. Bye.
Go on, get him!
Look, what is this? What do you want?
She wants to know what we want, Mac.
Are you perverts or something?
What you're calling perverts? Mind you, she wouldn't be bad to pass the time, would she, eh?
No. Something to do while she's remembering where the money's hid.
What money?
Listen to her, acting dumb.
Yeah. I mean, what do you think we are? Stupid. We know that Joyce told you where she hid the money.
Now listen, Monica, we don't want to have to get rough.
My name isn't Monica.
Don't give me that.
It's Lynn Warner. Look, if you don't believe me, find the prison. They'll tell you.
What are you reading?
She's bluffing. Find the prison. Yeah, you'd like us to do that, wouldn't you? Listen, if you're not Monica, how'd you know Joyce was in there?
Because I was in there with her. I got out today.
We heard Monica was getting out today.
She was. I mean, she did, but so did I.
She could be telling the truth.
Yeah, maybe. Either way, she's a friend of Joyce's. We'll send Jules in to talk to her, tell her we got her friend. And if she don't tell us where the money is, it'll be too bad for you no matter what your name is.
Karen! You didn't make it to the prison reform group meeting the other night.
No, remember I told you? I was tied up.
It was fantastic. Well, there are these guys there, you know, ex-prisoners. Some of them had been locked up for months, just waiting for their trial. And you should have heard what some of them said about their lawyers.
I mean, some of them shouldn't be allowed to practice. All they're interested in is their fees.
Well, that's only one side of the story. I'm sure the lawyers see it differently.
Of course they do. Well, they're not getting locked up, are they? Well, Peta was saying...
Peta?
Peta Clements, our sociology tutor.
Oh, right.
He was at the meeting. He's been in prisons lots of times, you know, doing research. He was saying that when you get locked up, you just lose all your identity. You just become a number to them, a statistic. I wonder what sort of person becomes a prison officer.
All sorts, I guess.
There'd have to be something funny about you. Well, that's what Peta said. Oh, I made a cassette of the meeting like you suggested. Do you want to come round to my place tonight? We could listen to it together.
Oh, couldn't I just borrow it?
Sure. Please yourself. Are you coming to Peter's church?
No, I've got some business in town, but I'll catch up with you later.
Okay.
Thanks for the cassette.
desperate trying to steal that old bomb.
I wasn't trying to steal it.
I can't hear you.
Then turn the bloody thing off then. Joyce's.
There's no need to shout. You've come for all that money, have you?
How did you know about that?
I might need this, but I've got eyes. Be glad to get rid of the stuff. If that Harry come round here, they'd be hell to pay. Well, go on. I haven't got all day.
Can I help you?
Yes, I'm looking for Steve Wilson.
I'm afraid he's not here. What name is it?
Karen Travers.
Oh, yes, Steve's told me all about you. Shouldn't you be at university? I'm sure the authorities wouldn't be too pleased if they knew you were running all over town.
Are you Steve's new secretary?
No, I thought he would have told you. Steve's leaving, Mr. Baldwin. Coming into practice with Daddy and myself. It's a small family business. Excuse me. Hello. Hello, Steve, darling. It's all going fine. Oh, don't worry about it, darling. You just stay there with Daddy and settle everything. I've tied up all the loose ends here. Yes, of course I can manage. No, don't worry about it.
Only it's a long way, and I couldn't let Harry go without his afternoon tea.
No hurry.
I do worry. You see, he's not been well. It's his chest. He hardly sleeps at night, wheezing and coughing all the time.
I'm not surprised, love. It's the house you live in. It's damp.
It is damp. They're going to sell the place soon. Don't know what'll happen to us then. Well, I'll bring it back when I've been down the shop.
Deaf as a post, she is. That's why she shouts. Well, did you get the money?
Yeah, thanks.
Oh, don't thank me. I'm glad to get rid of it. They live in sin, you know. Ed and Ori. Not that there's much sin about it at their age. It's like everything else around this place, you know, too old and run down. Still, two pensions are better than one. Well, did you lock up the car and turn on the alarm?
No.
Oh, you wouldn't. You wouldn't care if someone came along and pinched it. You'd be surprised the type who get round here. They've got no respect for other people's property.
Love, this'll warm you up.
Thanks. It's all right. I can manage. I saw Madge just now. She's getting deafer than ever. I had to shout to make myself heard. She had a woman with her in the garage, looking at the car. I wonder if she's got to sell it. Be a pity. She loves that old car.
A postman came while you were out. Another reminder. They say we've got to get out. They say they're pulling the place down. I don't know where we're going to go.
We're not going anywhere. We're going to stay here. At least until your cough gets better.
But they're pulling the place down, Edith.
Ah, they always say that. Look at that old place up by the railway. They've been going to pull it down for years, and it's still there. You wait till they get here. I'll tell them a thing or two. They daren't throw a sick man out in the street. You'll see. Now, drink your tea up while it's still hot.
Hello, Karen. What brings you here? Obviously not my tutorial.
Sorry, I had some business in town.
Business before wisdom, huh? The scourge of the decadent West.
I hope my missing your tute isn't going to bring down democracy.
No, it's probably too late for that anyway.
It is. In that case, maybe we should all give up the struggle.
Never. Not while the rough red still runs in the veins. Get Suzanne here to lend you a note.
Okay, I promise I'll be there next time.
You better. There won't be many more chances. I'm taking some time off to do some research.
Oh, when?
As soon as I can arrange a replacement.
Who's that likely to be?
Probably Tom Burton.
Oh, no.
Tom's a very good tutor.
Yes, if you don't mind your bottom being pinched. Well, I was back and blue after his toots last year. Besides, he's so boring. He'll never discuss the real issues, and he's a chauvinist pig.
Enough. Enough. I can't stand here and let you malign a colleague. Go and do it somewhere else. Besides, I'd like to have a private word with Karen.
Oh. Okay, I know when I'm not wanted.
Is it about my paper?
No, not exactly. The research I'm doing is at the Wentworth Detention Centre.
Oh.
The problem with this sort of thing is that it's very hard to get at the truth. The authorities just want to protect their reputation, and the women are understandably suspicious. I wondered if you could help me break down a few barriers.
Well, I don't see what I could do.
Well, why don't you come up to my office and we'll discuss it? Over a glass of sherry, perhaps.
Well, I have to be getting back. I can't afford to be late.
Don't worry, I'll drive you back when we're finished. Make sure the screws don't welcome you home with rubber hoses.
They're not that bad.
They're not that good either, are they?
You seem to be having a lot of visitors lately, Martin.
Yes, I must be popular.
You or that money you got stashed away?
Told you, I don't know where that money is. You're just imagining things.
Hello, Joyce. How they been treating you?
How do you think?
All right if I give her a smoke?
As long as that's all you give her.
I was searched on my way in. Heard from Harry lately?
Am I likely to?
Thought he might have got word to you. A lot of your friends are asking after you. As a matter of fact, we've got one of them staying with us at the moment. Quiet little thing, won't say a word.
Maybe she can't get a word in edgeways, huh?
Oh, can I have a word with you?
Yeah, sure.
We've got Monica.
Yeah, but she's not talking.
She better, or you'd better. Otherwise, Vince and Mac are going to be ruining her pretty face.
Pretty?
Monica!
What does she look like?
You know what she bloody looks like.
Yeah, but you don't. How do I know you're not bluffing?
We've got her all right. She's blonde, about 20.
What's going on?
Nothing. Nothing's going on. You've got the wrong one.
What's so funny?
Oh, Harry's two mates. Geez, I told you they were dumb.
Would they been caught?
No, worse luck. Somehow they found out I told Monica where the money was hid, so they tried to kidnap her.
trouble is they picked up the wrong girl. Yeah, they must have grabbed Lynn Warner. Yeah, that'd be it.
Lynn?
Well, they both got out the same day, didn't they? She's talking about dumb.
Well, it's not bloody funny, Joyce.
Yeah, oh, go on, they're all talk. They won't hurt her.
Yeah, well, they better not either. Or Monica, for that matter. Because if they do, you might find you're not in a fit state to spend that money when you get out.
You play cards?
No.
Pity. We could have played for some of that dough you got stashed away.
Look, I told you, I don't know anything about the money. You've got the wrong person.
Yeah? Well, you better hope your friend Joyce comes good. Otherwise, you'll be taking a ride. Money or no money.
You talk like something out of a comic.
Watch it!
Don't hurt her, Vince.
You keep out of this. Who's that? That you, Julie?
Yeah.
What did she say?
She said we got the wrong woman.
I told you.
Shut up.
What do we do now, Vince?
I'm trying to think. This Monica Ferguson, you reckon she'd be in the phone book?
Oh, hardly.
Well, we've got to find her. You'll have to go to the prison and find out where she lives.
I can't go walking in and out there every 5 minutes. Why don't one of yous two go?
You know why. They'd spot us in a minute. Look, how soon can you visit Martha again?
Not this week. The screws are beginning to get suspicious.
Well, why don't we ask the screws?
What?
Well, we could say we're old friends. Don't have her address.
Oh, yeah, but they're not going to tell us. I'll just have to write Martha a letter.
Well, that'll take days.
You got a better idea?
What do we do with her?
I would have thought that was obvious. We can't get away from here till we get that money. And we can't let her go while we're stuck here.
Hold on, Harry. Hold on. I'll nip down the hall and get you a glass of water.
No, don't fuss. It's bloody cold down that passageway and you don't want to go running up and down for me all the time.
We ought to get the doctor in again.
Yes, I might go down and see the doctor tomorrow. The fresh air will do me good.
Might be raining.
Well, you'd have to go through the rain to fetch him, wouldn't you? I'll see him tomorrow.
Damn thing. What are you doing here?
That's just the question I was going to ask you, young man. We live here.
Not anymore, you don't. I bought this place weeks ago. I'm pulling it down. We'll start tomorrow morning.
No, you can't. Harry's sick. He can't move.
That's not my problem, missus. I've got Wharton standing by. You'll just have to move.
Where to?
I don't know. You've had loads of warning for the agent. What about the salvos?
No.
I'm not asking you, I'm telling you. The wreckers start tomorrow morning. I'm not holding them up just because you've been too bloody lazy to go and look for another place to live.
We've tried. Where can you go somewhere you can afford on a pension?
I don't care. If you're not out of here by 6 o'clock tonight, I'll get the police. You're trespassing.
What are we going to do, Harry?
Well, not much we can do. Try the salvos, I suppose.
Well, thanks for the lift.
That's all right. We're early. Would you get into trouble if we chatted for a bit?
Oh, no, probably not. Ted's not bad. He's better than some of the others anyway.
Yes, that's what I wanted to talk to you about, actually.
What?
This thesis I'm doing on the prisoners. The point is, what good do these studies ever do? They never achieve anything.
Why do you bother?
Because there is a way to achieve something. I mean, who creates the conditions in the prison? Not the prisoners. The staff. They're the ones we've really got to understand if we want to get anything changed. They're the ones I really want to observe. Without them noticing, of course.
It's a bit sneaky, isn't it?
Yeah. But how else can I do it? They wouldn't let me through the gate if they knew what I was up to. You know how sensitive they are about publicity. Yeah. You've been in there almost a year. You know these people. You could give me a lot of background information.
Well, I don't know. I really will have to think about it.
What's the hurry?
It's the Deputy Governor. He's a great stickler for punctuality.
Is he really?
Pretty flash public transport you came back in, Mrs. Travers.
He's one of my tutors.
You will in future restrict your meetings to the classroom.
I don't think I can do that, Mr. Fletcher. He's going to be doing a thesis on criminal psychology. He'll be working here.
Well, you've really done it this time, haven't you, Fletcher?
It's Mr. Fletcher to you, and what exactly have I done?
Always going on about me having the money from that bloody robbery. More people have started believing you.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised.
No? Then you won't be surprised to hear that they've kidnapped Lynn Warner.
What?
They reckon I told her where the money's hid. Now, if they hurt her, it's all your fault.
Who's kidnapped her?
Some mates of my husband's. Julie Barker and her boyfriend.
Where are they holding her?
Oh, how would I know? Probably at their flat. Yeah, they're dumb enough to take her home.
Give me the visitor's book. Their address will probably be in there. And call the police.
Get away from that window.
I'm just looking.
She's not doing any harm.
Will you shut up? Someone might see her now. Get away from there.
Oh, God, it's so boring, all this waiting around.
Yeah, well, you better get used to it. How much longer are you going to be?
Almost finished.
Well, you haven't told them you've got the girl, have you?
Of course I haven't, stupid.
All right, all right, all right. I just thought the screws might read the letter, that's all.
Vince. I don't know why you ever got mixed up with him. He's bloody useless.
Yeah, I know. What have you written?
Dear Martha, we still haven't found our lost kitten. The woman we got in touch with this afternoon doesn't know where it is. Remember that woman you said was looking after the kitten? If we knew her address, I'm sure we could recover it. The children do miss it so. And so on and so on.
Yeah, that's great.
But I still think it'd be better if one of you two went to visit Martha.
Look, I told you we can't. Besides, I could hardly send him. He'd only mess it up. And if I went, he'd probably let her go.
Mm. Yeah, well, I'll take it round to Wentworth. See if the bloke at the gate will hand it in for me. That should speed things up a bit. Oh, get it on the way out. Just keep her quiet.
What time is it?
What difference does it make? You aren't going anywhere.
Look, I'm meant to be going home today and the last bus goes at 8.
Yeah, well, don't worry about it because you won't be catching it.
I think I will.
What?
I said I think I will be catching it.
Hello? Oh, hello, Blossom. Geez, I told you not to ring me. What if the missus had answered? No, she's not here yet. Yes, of course she is. She just hasn't turned up yet. What? Yep. Now, there's nothing to worry about. I told you, she's going to get me off the hook. Yeah. We'll have the cash in a couple of days and then we can get together again. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it too.
Woo, Fred, I'm
home. Oh, gotta go, Blossom. She's here. Yeah, bye.
Hello, Dal. I'm home.
G'day, Moni.
Well, struth, that's not much of a welcome, is it? You could at least say you're pleased to see me.
Well, of course I am, love. It's... Well, no hard feelings?
Oh, of course not, Fred. Who was that on the phone just now?
Oh, it was... that was a bookie getting a bit impatient about his money. Where have you been? I got real worried about you. Nearly had a police search party organised.
We won't have any more dobbing into the cops now, will we, Fred?
No, love. No more cops. Would you like to sit down? I'll make you a nice cup of tea.
Yeah, tap, huh?
Oh, can I put this away for you?
Get your grubby little paws off that. Sorry, love, I didn't mean to snap your head off. I got the money.
Already? You got the money for the shop already?
Just the deposit.
Yeah? Oh, that's beaut, Ronnie. You're a real bonzer, you know that? You really are. Oh, I'll make it up to you, I promise. You'll never regret it.
Yeah, well, you'd better make it up to me or you're the one who'll be having regrets. Tell you what, why don't you take this, go down to the pub and get a few beers under your belt. You always did perform better when you'd had a few.
Okay, sweetheart. You're the boss.
Too bloody right.
What they say?
Oh, Harry.
What's the matter, love? Won't they take us in?
Oh, they'll take us in all right. Oh, Harry, they want to split us up.
Why?
Because we're not married. You're to go with the men and I'm to go with the other women, they said.
Did you tell them I wasn't feeling the best?
Didn't make any difference.
And they call themselves Christians.
No, Harry, that's not right. Some people just have other opinions, that's all. They said they'd see that you were looked after particularly well. That's something, I suppose.
Now, you listen to me, Edith. We've been together for 10 years now, and we ain't going to split up for anyone. No, not now.
But what are we going to do, Harry? We haven't got any money. And you're sick. You need someone to look after you.
Well, I'm not that bloody sick. And besides, no one can look after me better than you can, Ed. We'll be all right, you'll see. We've got some money for food and tomorrow we'll find a little room of our own somewhere. Let them keep their bloody charity.
Yes, that's right. We'll stay here the night.
No, Ed. If they won't let us stay together, then we won't stay at all. We'll sleep in the park tonight.
Oh. I'll be cold, Harry.
Don't worry, love. We'll find some wood and build a little fire. It'll be fine sleeping under the stars. Quite romantic.
Oh. It won't matter. Just for one night if we split up.
Now, don't start that again, love. No, not for one night. No, not ever. Now, come on.
Night, tonight, I'll see my Fred tonight. One for Joyce, one for Fred, and one for me. But there will be no more hysteria. Hurry home, Fred. Ta-ti, ta-ti, ta-ta, ta-ti, ta-ta, 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 ta-ta. Hello, Dad. Well primed, are you?
Yeah, lovey.
There you are. That's for being a good boy.
$12,000. All in cash.
Yeah, well, I figured the sort of bookie you'd be dealing with, he wouldn't take a check.
Oh, geez, you're a butler, Monty. Well, I better take it round to him straight away.
Oh, no, you don't. If you think I'm letting you loose with that kind of money, you better think again. You can wait till tomorrow, I'll take it to him myself.
What's the matter? Don't you trust me?
Is the Pope a Catholic? Besides, you've got to earn it first. Come, Fred.
Here you are, love. That'll take the chill out of you.
Yeah. Yeah, mate. Have a swig of this. You look as if you could do it. Bit different from the old days. Geez, it could be cold at nights in the Isa. But I don't reckon it was ever as nippy as this.
Like you said, you were younger then. Never you mind, love. You can take it.
It was all those years in the mine it did for me. Dirty, stinking, bloody coal dust. Never been the same since.
Oh, thanks.
Jesus, bloody freezing.
I'll go and get a bit more wood.
No, don't eat.
Oh, I'll be all right.
No, don't stay here. Don't leave me.
Oh, no. I won't leave you, dear.
You're a good woman, Edie. I don't know what I'd do without you.
Want to see the senior staff, Mr. Davidson?
Yes, please, come in. Sit down, please. There is another chair, Mr. Fletcher.
I prefer to stand, thank you, Mrs. Davidson.
I have some news which will, I'm afraid, affect the routine here a little. The department has given permission for a psychologist to visit Wentworth. As I understand it, Dr. Clements, the psychologist, we'll choose about half a dozen subjects from among the women here and do an in-depth study on each of them.
What a ridiculous waste of time.
Oh, I don't know. Psychologists are very useful sometimes. But you're right, it'll certainly upset routine.
And you, Mr. Fletcher?
Beg your pardon, ma'am?
Your thoughts on the matter?
Not for me to say, Mrs. Davidson. He certainly won't be psychoanalyzing me.
I was referring to the disruption of the prison routine.
We'll cope.
Yes, I'm sure. Hello? Yes, thank you. Send him up, please. Well, he's just arrived. You'll all have a chance to meet him.
Hmm. I can't wait.
I know it's going to be hard.
Hard? It's impossible.
But I am sure the department knows what it's doing, Miss Bennett.
Oh, of course they do. They come up with all these airy-fairy ideas, but they don't have to cope with the consequences. How would they like someone prying around their offices?
Well, I just hope the women don't get treated as statistics. The system's depersonalized enough as it is.
So it should be.
Good morning, Dr. Clements. I'm Erica Davidson, Governor of Wentworth.
Delighted to meet you, Mrs. Davidson.
This is Mr. Fletcher, our Deputy Governor, Miss Bennett, and Mrs. Jackson, our senior officers.
How do you do? I'd like to say that I really appreciate this opportunity of working here, and I promise I won't get under your feet too much.
What exactly is it you're looking for, Dr. Clements?
Call me Peter, please. Well, I think we all know the type of background that many criminals come from. Broken families, poor working class conditions, overcrowded accommodation, etc., etc. What I want to look at is why some people from this type of background develop a criminal mentality and why others grow towards more normal social behaviour.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Well, perhaps you would like to have a look around the prison.
I'd like that very much, thank you.
Mr. Fletcher?
Yes, follow me, Dr. Clements.
I could have danced all night, I could have danced all night, and still have begged for more.
Oh, morning, Tiger. I was just going to bring you some breakfast in bed.
Oh, thanks, Monty, but I thought I'd nip this money straight down to Elf.
You just sit down. I said I'd take it.
Oh, but it's no trouble, lovey.
I said I'll take it, and I will. Now, just get that breakfast into the bedroom.
What you got there, lovey?
Never you mind. Get out of it! few things to do, Fred. I'll be back soon. You just rest up. Get your strength back.
What the hell's she up to?
Did you hear the news, Bee?
What about Joyce's mates being picked up? Yeah, just wait until Julie gets here, then the fun will start. She'll know who dobbed them in.
Don't worry, love. If they were going to send her here, she would have been here by now.
Yeah, she'd probably gone to Fairley. Still, at least now I know Monica's safe.
Oh, I'm going to miss old Mon. It won't be the same without her.
You've got a short memory, Lizzie.
Like I said, live and let live.
Pay attention, all of you. This is Dr. Peta Clements. He's a psychologist. He'll be working here for a while.
Why aren't you at university, Travers?
Because my tutor's standing right next to you, Miss Bennett.
Don't be smart.
You ask.
Ladies, I hope I can rely on you to help me as much as you can. I'm sure we're going to get along together very well.
Gonna do a bit of work on the couch, are we, Doc?
Unfortunately not. Well, oh. I hope I see you all later.
Maybe.
What do you think, Bea? We're going to help him. He really is on our side.
Yeah, of course he will. I've got a few stories I can spin him myself. Those smart asses will believe anything.
Yes?
Brought Bea Smith in to see you.
Ah, good. Yes, she's the one who's in charge here, is that right?
No, Mrs. Davidson is. But if you mean she's the leader amongst the women, then you're right.
Yes, of course. I'm sorry. Show her in, please.
Bea?
Good morning, Mrs. Smith. Or may I call you B?
Well, you could call me Your Majesty if you like. I don't care.
B.
That's all right, Mrs. Jackson. I'd like to talk to Queen Bee alone, if you wouldn't mind, please. Cigarette?
What's the catch?
No catch?
Aye, come on. Nobody does nothing for nothing. Especially not me.
All right. I need your help.
To do what?
I understand that you have some influence among the women here.
That's right.
My job would be a lot more successful if I had their complete cooperation. Of course, I don't expect your help for nothing. I would be prepared to provide a few little things that you might not be able to get in here. Unofficially, of course. Am I getting through?
Loud and clear.
I'll be coming in and out every day, so I'll be open to requests, within reason, of course. Don't expect alcohol or drugs.
If it had been drugs, you wouldn't be making a second trip.
I think we'll get along just fine, don't you?
Well, I think they're overrated. It's getting so you can't do a damn thing these days without getting a clean bill of health from a psychiatrist.
I agree. Next, they'll be wanting officers to undergo psychological examinations before they're allowed to even enter the service.
You're both missing the point. He's here to discover the reasons behind criminal behaviour. It's like cancer research. Unless you take every opportunity to find the causes of cancer, you're never going to find a cure.
Do you really believe they'll ever cure criminal behaviour?
Well, that'd make prisons obsolete.
That's a general idea, isn't it?
What do you think, Meg?
What about?
Dr. Peta Clements and his bag of tricks.
Well, I'm not sure. He may do some good. He's well qualified.
Qualified for what? Sticking his nose into other people's business. I've met his type before.
Where was that? The army?
Well, there's no harm in giving him a chance. He probably knows more about criminals than we do.
It's just like old times having you working back here in the laundry, Karen.
Yeah, I know where I'd rather be, though.
Will all your lectures be cancelled now that that Clements bloke's in here?
What do you think? He's not the only teacher in the whole place.
Oh, don't be so smart-ass. We haven't all had your advantages, you know.
No, I'm sorry. There's another guy, Tom Burton. He'll be taking over while Peter's here. Oh. I just don't have any classes today. I wish I could study in the library like the other students.
But you're not like other students. You're special.
You don't have to remind me, Lizzie.
How'd it go, B?
Oh, a bit of a weirdo, if you ask me. I couldn't make out what he was on about half the time.
Them college blokes are all the same.
Yeah, and got tickets on myself. Still, I reckon it might do us a bit of good to go along with him.
What? Not likely. I'm not going to tell any bloody shrink about my sex life.
If I say we're going to go along with him, we are going to go along with him, no matter what sort of questions he asks. Right, Lizzie? Besides, he said he'd do the odd favour for the girls who helped him out.
What do you mean, favour?
Oh, like bringing in the occasional present just to show his appreciation. I reckon we can spin him a few yarns for that, don't you?
Oh, he wants the truth. Can't you get that into your thick skulls?
Oh, hello. What have we got here? His new assistant. Or is it goodbye, Steve Wilson? Hello, Peta Clements.
No, that's not it at all. Look, somebody comes in here who wants to help us, and all you people can think about is how to get the better of him.
Oh, good. Now, see what a higher education does for you?
You Elf?
Who wants to know?
I'm Monica Ferguson, Fred's wife. Come to fix you up what he owes you. You needn't bother to count it, it's all there.
How much?
12,000. And I want a receipt.
A receipt? For what?
The 12,000.
What is this, some sort of a con?
Oh, now look, what do you want about?
Look, I don't know what he's told you, but he doesn't know me this much. Only 2 grand.
Sure.
Look, see for yourself. Mind you, if you don't want all this, I'll have it.
Just wait till I get my hands on that slimy little weasel. I'm going to break every bone in his body.
Is it absolutely necessary? Access to the personal files is restricted, you know.
Yes, you see, it's important to compare the prisoner's version of their crime with the official report. Well, everyone's inclined to stretch the truth a little.
I take it you mean the prisoners. Well, surely you aren't suggesting the police reports are false.
I'm a psychologist, Mrs. Davidson, and I'm afraid my training makes me think along devious lines. I take it I may view the files. I have got permission from the department.
Very well. But I am relying on your absolute discretion.
Scout's honour.
Come in.
Those medical reports you asked for, Mr. Davidson.
Oh, thank you, Dr. Miller. Have you met Dr. Clements?
No, I haven't.
Our resident doctor, Greg Miller.
Pleased to meet you.
Likewise. I've heard about your project. I must say I'm very interested.
Really? Oh, your assistance would be invaluable to me. Have you got a few minutes? We could have a chat.
Oh, by all means.
Good. Thanks for your help, Mrs. Davidson. I'll be back later, if that's all right. Yes, you see, it's about this phenomena of prison life, the pill parade. This reliance on drugs. Is it purely a manifestation of boredom, or would the same subjects do the same thing on the outside?
Well, the boredom of prison life is certainly a contributing factor.
Yes, of course, but, I mean, wouldn't these same subjects respond to the same negative stimuli if they were in an outside situation? I mean, as a suburban housewife.
I'm sorry, I don't quite follow you.
Oh. Look, what I'm trying to get at is, how does the suburban mentality compare with the criminal mentality? I mean, is there in fact a difference? Where do you draw the line between the everyday working class woman and the shoplifter, the harassed mother and the baby basher?
Works fascinating. If it does anything to reduce recidivism, then it's more than worthwhile.
I suppose so. It just gives me a funny feeling that we're under the microscope rather than the prisoners.
Well, he has to get to know what the officers are like in order to evaluate the prisoner's reaction to them.
Mm. And we all know what they think of us. Always have and always will.
You're not going along with Jim and Vera on this, are you, Meg? We need intellectuals who are concerned about the system. Their analysis is very helpful. Well, don't you think so?
I guess we can't all be college graduates.
Sorry, getting on my high horse again.
You'll be doing that rather a lot lately.
Forgive me?
Greg, not here.
All right, how about tonight then?
Hello, Mrs. Jackson. Greg, I wonder if you could spare some time this afternoon to continue our conversation. I'd like your opinion about the inmate's attitude to authority.
Yes, of course.
I must get back to work.
Meg, what?
I'll let you know later.
Lovely lady.
Yes.
Oh, you little beauty.
Bastard, Fred. You rotten little bastard. I only did it for you.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses heal.